All right, thanks, guys. A very relaxed Zap Judah out of Brooklyn, New York, will square off against Juan Torres. Friday Night Fights on the Dish is presented by Budweiser with the Grand Casino in Tunica, Mississippi. Juan Torres, 30 years of age, born in Mexico, fighting out of South Lakeside, California. He's 30 years of age, a record of 11-5, with two knockouts in his career, coming off a split decision controversial loss to Hector Camacho Jr. And tonight he's going against Zab Judah, the 21-year-old out of Brooklyn, New York, an alternate on the 1996 Olympic team for the United States, 5'7", 140 pounds. He is 19-0 with 14 knockouts. He's already held the USBA junior welterweight title belt. Zab Judah, a very interesting young man who has a bright future in front of him. Zab Judah has a bright future in boxing. He's already ranked number one by the IBF in the junior welterweight division. The Brooklyn native won the USBA championship last year against Irish Mickey Ward. As seen here on the Deuce in July, he knocked out Otilio Villarreal. He has wins against Darryl Tyson and Wilfredo Negron as well. Judah realizes that a world championship is in his future, but he's in no hurry to get the title belt.
I'm not in a rush. I'm just waiting patiently, just keep winning fights by fights. Right now, I'm a rookie in the game. I sit back and I watch De La Hoya and Whitaker and Trinidad and Vernon and these guys and just learn. Those guys are the veterans at the top right now. And I just sit back and watch those guys and just, you know, play the rookie part right now. And then when it's my time, everybody gonna know.
He's very confident, but with a lot of savvy. Zab Judah. Let's take a look at the rules as governed by the state of Mississippi. Three knockdown rule is in effect, so is the standing eight count. Fighter can be saved by the bell only in the final round. Only the referee can stop the fight. Accidental cuts, they'll go to the scorecards after half the rounds are complete. Zab Judah with trainer Ronnie Shields, and Zab with a hearty hello to his manager Lou Duva, who's back in a New Jersey hospital, had knee transplant surgery, got a new knee put in, so best of luck to Lou. And Zab's ready to roll against Juan Torres. Torres, a former six-time kickboxing world champion, got a late start in the professional boxing game, turned pro in September of 1994 at the age of 26 years old. We'll take a look at the knockout ratio for Judah, 70%, 10 of his 14 in the first two rounds. Torres, just two knockouts in his 16 professional bouts. Not a big ring, 18 feet by 18 feet inside the ropes.
Bob, you always hear this, the beginning is very important. I think it's really relevant here because Torres has had problems in the first round and Zab Judah can be a very fast starter. So I believe that this first round is really, really important because Torres has been knocked out one time in the first round and in his last fight, which was a terrific fight for him, he lost an undisputed 10-round decision to Hector Camacho Jr. He was down and almost out in the first round.
He was knocked out by Juan Lopez, and down goes Torres.
Maybe I shouldn't have said anything. But, you know, Judah, tremendous talent, real fast starter. Torres' weakness has always been getting out of that first round. And obviously, the weakness continues. He does not get out of the first round.
And Torres made a half-hearted, at best, effort to get up. He's arguing now, but Fred Steinwander was right in his face, counting to 10. And we wondered about Torres coming into this fight because yesterday he told us after his long kickboxing career, if he was just going to be a journeyman, he was going to look to become a manager and a trainer. And maybe he came to just collect a check.
And I tell you right now, Zab Judah is not happy with this. He's a fighter. This kid's a talented kid, one of the most talented kids out there. They're talking about him in the same breath of guys like Pernell Whitaker with the style and also being a southpaw. He's not happy. He's a little, I'm sure that he would rather have a guy who's trying in there. And this guy did not look like he tried in there. I'm sorry, people don't like to hear that. But it did not look, I'm not taking the punches, but at the end there, it did not look like he gave a fighter's effort.
Yeah, I mean, we'll take a look at it. Yeah, he got hit. No question about that. Took a straight left hand to start things off. And then he took a right hand and he goes down right there. Now, that's not a punch that should knock you out at 10, I don't think, Teddy.
No, all the other punches missed. He finished with the hook, which is what you're supposed to do. In this case, of course, it was a southpaw hook. It was a right hook. You see the first punches, they don't land, and the right hook, which he finishes with, does land on the tip of the chin. There's no doubt about it. That's the most vulnerable spot, the tip of the chin. Only he knows how bad it was. The thing that I have a question with is that he's laying there like he's completely out of it, and once 10 is counted, all of a sudden he's recovered. That's where I have the problem, that he didn't really need help getting up. He wasn't staggering. Once it was to 10, all of a sudden he was okay. That recovery time at the point that it took place is a little bit suspect.
And now he's saying he's okay, and he made a gesture against the ropes, and not to knock Juan Torres at all, but looked like he had no intent after getting tagged with a good shot of bothering to get up.
No, it looked like the thing that his intent was to hear the 10 count, and then all of a sudden to get up, quite honestly, because there was no staggering, there was no problem once he got past 10. You would think that when he got up, he would have staggered a little bit. He looked fairly recovered. It was a clean punch on the tip of the chin. Only he knows for sure.
So Zab Judah stops Juan Torres in round number one, and Zab picks up win number 20 and knockout number 15, but even he cannot be all that satisfied. A right hand to the chin puts Torres down, right on the button, but then he makes no effort to get up until it's too late. Here's Brian and Max.
And we want to see a little more, too. I mean, as far as Zab Judah is concerned, and we wanted to see Zab Judah fight, you know, what more can he do? But we want to see a little bit more. But that's how fast this guy is, and he took care of business.
Well, Torres, you have to remember, he recently beat the number two guy in the WBA. Torres recently went the distance with Hector Camacho Jr. and lost a controversial decision. So this was a legit guy despite his record, but there was something about Judah, if Torres did quit, that made Torres think, I don't want to fight this guy, or maybe Judah really did catch him on the point of the chin with that right hook and just knocked him out. Look, Judah is a tremendous, exceptional talent. The only guy I'd really like him to see fight at this moment is either Sharmbay Mitchell or the winner of Tsu and Gonzalez. That either one of those guys would provide Judah with tests and would let us know if Judah is among the very best pound-for-pound fighters in the world. I'm hoping he is, and that eventually he fights Shane Mosley.
Well, the guys at Main Events had said that within the year, they want him. Within this calendar year, they want him fighting for a world title. It'll be a big step up in class. And, hey, Shane Mosley is there just below, and the big welterweights just up above. Could be an exciting future. There's so many good fighters right in there for him to fight. You think he's at Mosley caliber almost now?
I think his talent, his potential, Judah's potential is like a Jones, a Roy Jones Jr., or a Floyd Mayweather Jr. These guys that you can really argue is maybe the best pound for pound in the world. Now with Judah, it's still too early to tell. Eddie Hobson, I harken back to that all the time. Eddie Hobson, another Main Events fighter, looked spectacular, got a title shot against Tracy Patterson, and was knocked out in the second round. So the question is Judah an Eddie Hobson, or is he a Pernell Whitaker? I think he's much closer to Whitaker than Hobson. I'm at least keeping my fingers crossed. Based on fights like this and the Darryl Tyson fight, he looks like he could provide a guy like Shane Mosley already with all he could handle.
Well, an exciting start, an exciting but brief start, but Vernon Forrest is still up ahead on Friday Night Fights. Take a programming note right now. Again, for you draft nicks out there, the NFL draft starts tomorrow. Chris Berman, Mike Tirico, Mel Kiper Jr., and a cast of thousands bring to you 17 hours of live draft coverage on both ESPN and ESPN2. It starts noon tomorrow on ESPN. Coming up next on Friday Night Fights, we've got the Prince. What happened to the Prince? Is it the same Prince? We'll be back. Well, and that fast, right there, Zab Judah is now 20-0. We were talking about, and I mentioned that Main Events, they'd said that they wanted to fight for a title within the year. Let's find out exactly what his timetable is. If he knows at this point, management could be dictating what's happening with Zab, but find out from the man himself. Let's go to Bob Papa and Teddy Atlas standing by with Zab Judah.
All right, thanks, guys. And Zab Judah stops Torres in round number one, and Zab, good right hand right on the chin, right?
Yeah, I mean, it was a... First of all, I don't know what shot did it. First of all, I want to thank God for giving me this beautiful win. And it was a shot that when I think it was a short hook. And when I hit him, he just went down. So I looked at him to make sure. I thought he was playing games or something. But you know, I don't pick the opponents. I just go in there and fight it. And I'm looking to fight better opponents. Shane Mosley, Teron Millett, the rest of those guys. Sharmbay Mitchell, bring them on.
Teddy, would you have rather gotten some rounds here since you're so close to a world title shot? Were you a little disappointed that he didn't get up?
Well, I would rather go in there and fight a little bit longer to show the fans that Zab Judah is the real deal. But unfortunately, God blessed me with this first round knockout, and I can't help that.
Well, Zab, congratulations on a great effort. Unfortunately, Torres didn't want to fight. He got up afterwards and started arguing. But you get your 20th win, and we look forward to seeing you the rest of the year.
For sure, for sure. And I just want to say hi to my mom, and I love you.
All right, Zab Judah gets win number 20 and knockout Brooklyn, number 15. Brooklyn is well represented here in Tunica, Mississippi. Let's send it back to Brian and Max, guys.